everybody. You're very welcome to today's episode of Club Choice Chats. We're speaking with Emmet Staunton, the operations manager up at Headfort Golf Club. Emmet, you're very welcome. How are you?
Thanks, Tiernan. I'm good, thank you. Nice sunny day outside, as you can't see from where I am here.
A nice June day. You're looking forward to getting the visitors back out in the golf course next week?
Absolutely. We've had member guests for the last 3 weeks, which has been nice seeing a few different people. But our, you know, we've been very keen on ensuring golf for our members. You know, COVID-19 has meant that we were closed for 7.5 weeks with no golf, and that's been very challenging. But our members have been very supportive of the club, and I've got back playing, and it's great to see them. It's good to see that public health news at the moment is good. So we're going into phase three next week, which will finally see 4 balls at 10 minutes, which is us back to our full capacity. Now, we've been in some, we've been lucky compared to some other clubs as well, insofar as we've 36 holes, but it's just been pretty full now from early in the morning to late in the evening since we reopened on the 18th of May.
Great. Well, I tell you, let's bring everyone back to the start. For people that don't know Headfort, give us an idea of your location and a bit of history as to where the club has come from.
Okay. Headfort Golf Club is in Kells, County Meath, in the Boyne Valley, about an hour from Dublin Airport down the motorway. It is built on mature parkland that has been an estate, an Elizabethan estate, so you're not the 1500s.
Okay.
The Marquesses of Headfort owned the land from here all the way up to Virginia, which would be the Park Lodge, Park Hotel in Virginia, which is a good 20 miles all around. Wow. The two courses are built right in front of the old Headfort House, which is still in operation as a school. And we have one course on one side of the old Headfort Road and one course on the other. So we would have had the old course, would have opened for play in 1929. Affiliated in 1930, and is on, as I would call it, this side of the road. So we've been playing there for quite a long time. That's where I learned to play golf. I'm from here originally.
Okay.
It's just pure parkland, lots of trees, very old style type golf course. At the end of the last century, so say 98, 99, we got the opportunity to take all the land that was in front of the house. And we were able to build the championship course, as we rebranded the new course, championship course, on there. So that's now 20 years old. However, it's built through massive trees. Previous Marquesses of Headfort would have been very established with botanical gardens, and would have been very, very much involved in Kew Gardens, etc. And so we would have some trees on the championship course that would only be seen here, anywhere in Europe. We've got a lot of South American trees, lots of American pines. We have trees that are 250 years old. We've got Turkish oaks. We've got, like, I'm not an expert in trees in any way, but we have a seriously mature parkland experience for everyone.
I think I might have actually hit most of those trees, Emmet, the last time I played.
Well, certainly on the old course, it's hard not to hit a tree. On the championship course, it is a bit more of a rolling golf course, more of an American style, much longer. It's built on there's about five holes that are built on two islands that were artificially made.
I didn't know that, right? Okay.
So, yes, if you go on, say, the third green, if you've ever played it, or if you ever get the chance to play it, the seventh green, 8, 9, 10, 11. Are all on two islands that were actually built artificially a couple of hundred years ago, and we've taken advantage of that when it comes to golf. And it's a nice experience for people to play. Certainly that golf course in its own right is one that is designed really to host big tournaments, and that's what we're looking to do.
And there's, I mean, the difference between the old and the new is pretty stark, and that obviously works in the favor for a course that is very visitor friendly, because you've got two very different challenges ahead of you. From the point of view of the existing old course, as we call it, Was it members' demand, or was it looking at the visitor experience as to the decision to take the new land and develop the new championship course?
The opportunity came our way, and we're lucky enough that we had members at the time who were able to be visionary enough to take that chance. I mean, it would have been simple enough for us to let that land go on to somebody else. It was on the market. It was offered to Headfort Golf Club. The company that at the time owned it felt that it would be ideal for a golf course. And the members at the time were visionary enough to build it. I don't think they had any massive strategy around who was going to necessarily play it. But it's turned out that it's given us a 36-hole complex that caters to all levels and from a parkland point of view, to all experiences.
And the design of the new course, it's Christy O'Connor Jnr?
Yes. Christy Jr. designed the course. I believe he always felt it was one of his better ones. I feel it's his best golf course. I don't think there's a weak hole on it. It's very much a golf course that has challenged the best.
Yeah.
He hosted a Challenge Tour event last year, an European Challenge Tour, and it was one of the lowest cuts and one of the lowest winning scores. And thankfully, the pros seem to really enjoy the experience of playing the golf course. Now, we do have 5 and 4 complexes of tees, so like the golf course is playable by all levels of golf.
And if you were to sort of, I suppose, describe the differences or the unique features of the old course versus the new, how might you do that to a visiting group?
I would say that the old course is an experience to be savored. It's very much, it's 100 years old, nearly coming up on 100 years old, with trees that are there that are 200 and 250 years old. It is very much in the style of golf course that you would have seen in private members clubs all over. Narrow,
quite tight, green,
very tight, small greens, not the longest, still off the back tees, it's 6,600 yards, you know, so it is a challenging course. I have a soft spot for it. I learned to play golf on it.
Grew up on it, yeah.
Yeah, so it, for me, it would be the course that I enjoy playing the most. And it very much gives a scenic experience. It's devilishly challenging at times, if not the longest. But it is a completely different experience to going across the road to the championship course, which is much bigger, wider fairways, bigger greens, very much American style tournament golf course. But like I said, with all the different tee complexes, we can vary the length of that course from 6,000 yards to 7,200 yards. So,
Great. You mentioned the Challenge Tour event that you hosted at the end of last year. Tell us a little bit of that.
Well, it was a great experience and a great opportunity for us. I used to work for the PGA many moons ago. So it really kind of fitted our profile ideally, the ability to know what to do to help to run that tournament, plus also the fact that the championship golf course was designed to host big events. We are hosting the Irish Close Championship in a couple of years, and we felt that was an ideal opportunity to take a big tournament. That is what Christy O'Connor had in mind when he designed that golf course, that there would be big tournaments on it, that it would challenge the best. It would provide a great experience for golfers at the highest level. And we really enjoyed having the event, really brought the membership together, the air of volunteerism, and the excitement around the event. When you have an event like that, you're busy, you're preparing, you're getting ready. But when the event comes, the tour run things so smoothly with all the volunteers or whatever, it just was a great experience. And that's what that golf course. That's when it's at its best. That's when it shines.
Yeah, no, the coverage and the feedback was super. You know, even from people who were external to it, like even guests of ours who we would have had Headfort on their itineraries and it was coming up, they would have picked it up through Sky Sports, for example, and they really thought the place really looked well. And there was, I mean, you were hit with some awful weather towards the end, you know, so, and it's the place still shone and it still got a great reaction.
It did. And it was a testament to the green staff and to the golf course itself and how we managed to have a tournament considering the amount of rain we had. The golf course just held up magnificently. We were unlucky. I mean, in Ireland, you could be hit with very local weather. I mean, 5-6 miles up the road, it didn't rain on the Sunday. We had astonishing rain in a couple of hours. However, the golf course held up, and the feedback from the professionals was very satisfying for us. They really enjoyed it. It really provided a tough challenge. It did show me how good these guys are.
Sure,
players. Some of the places they hit the golf ball, I knew it was possible, but I hadn't seen it before.
Yeah.
A lot of good players playing out of here. Our own head professional, Brendan McGovern, has played on seniors tour. You know, so, you know, we know what good players look like, but the next level of player coming up, the standard is very high, very high.
Yeah, yeah. One, I suppose, a facility that you guys have that in other courses can get glossed over, but I think it's a big part of what Headfort offers is your clubhouse there by the old course and Brendan and the shop. It's a very welcoming atmosphere when people go in. Quite a modern clubhouse, but upstairs the vistas and views and you know the food and drink on offer is really excellent, and it's kind of like the added touch to the golf experience when people come to play there.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear that. Thank you. We're quite proud of it now. You
know,
the clubhouse, it's two stories. The top story effectively is glass walls, just big windows, and sit and look out on the old course. And can also see across to the championship course. So from that end, it does offer a great respite after golf.
Lovely atmosphere.
More into that as we get through this current pandemic. We're very proud of our professional. He offers a great service. You know, he's got, you know, for people coming here to play, it can be important for the buggy service, all the electric trolleys, all the different golf clubs, the advice that he offers. And it was good to see how respected he was when the players came last year with the Challenge Tour. They were,
you know, of course,
waggling clubs. It's that golf expertise that Brendan brings to us that we're proud of. I'm proud of all our staff, I mean, our green staff. John Smith has been great, all our catering staff. You know, they had a real challenge last year getting that Challenge Tour event through the different clubhouse, players' lounges, the different experience. So we have all of that under our own umbrella. Nothing is franchised. Total control of what happens. And it's our number one goal is to offer a good experience to people coming to Headfort Golf.
Yeah.
First-class experience.
Yeah. And getting the visitors to Headfort to play the course is one thing, but the fact that there's a really nice vibe in Kells is great, and we do a lot of work with the Headfort Arms Hotel, which is just around the corner for me. So groups can come, they're like an hour from the airport or the ferry port, check into the hotel, they're on the first tee and 5 minutes around the corner, and then back into Kells for an evening for some beers and some grub. It's a great destination.
Yes, and we value our relationship with the Headfort Arms Hotel.
Yeah.
And our family long associated with Headfort Golf Club, and our partnership is very strong. It's really nice to have such a good facility right on the edge of the town. Players can stay in the hotel and walk down to the golf club and play golf. And, you know, when you have golf courses and members golf courses that don't have resort hotels on site, having somewhere like the Headfort Arms gives us a real leg up in attracting visiting groups. And I would recommend the Headfort Arms to anybody looking to have a golf experience.
There is,
probably the bar afterwards would be quite legendary.
Sometimes that the walk from the hotel to the golf course is enforced as opposed to, you know, just wanted, you know.
Yes.
Look, I think we've given everyone a great flavor of the place. Thanks a million for speaking to us, Emmet, and I look forward to seeing you in the next few weeks when we get up there to play.
Thanks, Tiernan, and looking forward to getting back to normal. Fingers crossed everyone out there is safe and well.
Thanks, Emmet. Talk to you soon.